Our response to the sermon is with an affirmation of faith. It is the Apostles' Creed. The Apostles' Creed in its earlier form was a baptismal creed. Let us confess the faith of our baptism as we say, I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. And now let us pray. O God, in whom we live and move and have our being, we give you thanks for the precious gift of life, for the life that you've given us in Jesus Christ, your only begotten Son. May we be good stewards of this life and pattern our life after the one who humbled himself, taking the form of a servant and was obedient throughout his life, even to the point of death, even death on the cross. We confess, O Lord, there are times when we have not been an obedient people, individually and collectively. We confess that too often we are shaped by what we see and read, what we see on Facebook, what we see on TikTok, what we see on the news or read in the news, rather than be shaped by the good news of the gospel and the way of Jesus Christ in the world. O Lord, wake us up. Wake us up from the old reality of going to church to the new and ever present reality of the need to be the church, the one that offers hope for the hopeless, love for the loveless, compassion for the compassionless, forgiveness for those who have done wrong. Truly, may we be a body of believers who bear witness to the risen Christ in and for the world. Forgive us for those times when we have not realized the importance of being the church for the world. And now we pray for the world. We acknowledge that whenever nationalism is on the rise, whenever nations put their own interest ahead of other nations' interests, when we get to the point that we're willing to take what is not ours to take, war breaks out. And so, O Lord, we know that nationalism is on the rise and the threat of war is on the rise. And we pray for the Prince of Peace to bring peace, for someone to be able to say, I don't like your attitude, and we can hear it. And we can respond with repentance. Lord, we pray for our leaders. We pray that you'll give them the courage to make the right decision rather than the politically expedient decision. We also pray, O Lord, for those in need of healing, in need of hope, in need of wholeness. We pray for those in hospital, for those in nursing homes. We pray for those who are facing death. May they call upon your name and may you answer them in their time of need on their journey to hope healing and wholeness in this life and in the next. We lift up to you the members of our church, particularly Bruce and Patty Cole, Gail and Louise Farmer, Stacy Rucker, Bridget Norwood, and David Neal. May they and we continue to grow in your grace. This we pray in the name of the one who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art out in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not in temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Let us continue to worship God with our tithes and all offering. And let us also pay attention to the global peace offering testimony. It is the Apostles' Creed said in many languages throughout the world.
Ndikulupirira Mungu Atate wampamvu yonse olengeza kumwamba ndiza pansi.
En Jesucristo, su único Hijo, Señor nuestro.
Jenž se počal z Ducha Svatého, narodil se z Marie Panny.
Die geleden heeft onder Pontius Pilatus, is gekruisigd, gestorven en begraven, nedergedaald ter helle.
Την τρίτη μέρα αναστάντα από τον νεκρόν, ανελθώντας τους ουρανούς, καθεζωμένον εν δεξιά Θεού Πατρός παντοδυνάμου.
وبشركه القديسين وبمغفره الخطايا
a test feltámadását és az örök életet. Amen.
Shadowed beneath blessings of this in all our days, we thank you, gracious God. Accept, we pray, not just these gifts of money, but also our lives freely offered in gratitude for all you have done for us. Use them in this place and wherever you might take us. Amen.
To share God's love to one and all. Now unto him who is able to do more than we can possibly think or even imagine in the church, in the world, and in the world to come, be all power and glory now and forever. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.